Hi, welcome to clickmyproject.com. Now we are going to see the title Customized Process for Handling Partial Information Relational Databases. Partial information arises when information is unavailable to users of a database when they enter new data. All commercial real-world relational database management systems implement some fixed way of managing incomplete information, but neither the RDBMS nor the user has any say in how the partial information is interpreted. So we have no information about that whether a value exists or not. So the SQL standard is also support the null value. So we need to handle all the partial informations. So user may want to specify the query operators that fill in the missing values in many possible ways. For that, we are using the partial information policy operators. So there are many queries of interest that an educationalist may want to pose after evaluating a PIP operator. So in order to solve those things, we have proposed the general notion of PIP operator for resolving various kinds of incompleteness and proposed index structures to support the efficient evaluation of PIP operators, and we maintain them incrementally when the database is dynamically updated. Now we are going to see the DFD diagram. First of all, we need to load the dataset values into the database. So inside the data set, whether it has the unknown information means we need to replace it. If we insert the new elements with the unknown elements means it automatically replaces the unknown element with the valuable thing. So for this we are taking the replacing null and tuple insertion process. For replacing the values, we are using three methods, that is aggregate operator operation, regression operator operation, and the final one is the PIP operator operation. So based upon three methods, we are replacing the values, that is we are replacing the null values, that is unavailable information. And finally, we are getting one value. Based upon that value, we are replacing the null value with the available information. Now we are going to see the project. The front end is NetBeans and the back end is MySQL. In the front end, inside the customized package, choose home.java and click run file. Click next. Click browse for choose the data set. Then choose wb.txt. Click file selector. And if you click load, the values present in the dataset are loaded into the database. Click next. Choose the query type, replacing null or tuple insertion. So now I'm going to use the replacing null. Click enter query and enter the query. Select star from the data set. Submit. So finally the values are shown here and click process. In that choose policy, aggregate operator, regression operator, or attribute operator. I'll choose aggregate operator. If it is aggregate operators, means we need to insert two aggregate operators and two attributes, each one separated by comma. Then I will give the aggregate operator check correct. Then attribute UER, comma country. Then check correct. Then replace. Find null value. So null value tuples are finder. Finally, it will show the null values found at the UER. Then click find value. Then click values. Then we are getting the average value for each country. Then click replace. So finally, the values are replaced here. The final output are shown here in that UER. No values are present as the unavailable. Click back. Then now I'm going to select tuple insertion. Enter query. In that, click index. Then index are created for each values and click show and then click next. Now I'm going to insert the values. So round year 2012. So percentage of female 25, UER 15, net ODA 14, and then submit. So the values are submitted and then click find index, select a method. Now I am going to choose regression operator. So inserted and then so the values are inserted. Okay, the values are inserted here. Then finally our null values are replaced by other values. Click exit. Now our project is successfully terminated. Thank you.